My name is Hans Koppi. I'm living in Berlin a long time. Now I'm a pensionist, but I have to do a lot of things. I have no or seldom free time. I'm a freelance collaborator in the Memorial for German Resistance Movement in Berlin. And then I'm the leader of the Berlin organization of persecuted people in the Nazi time, persecuted people who were arrested or survived concentration camps or jails in the Nazi time. And now are more organized the second or third generation and other peoples who are interested in history and more younger peoples who are interested in the actual debate against Nazism, racism, homophobia and other not so joyful parts of the society in which we live now. This is my work, what I'm doing, and okay, we preparing exhibitions and conferences and other in the next days on Sunday. On we will carry out a day for remembering of the people of the victims of fascism, and it's a day of action against Nazism, racism, and war. Yes. And this is a heritage of the German resistant movement, and this is the heritage of the the people who are sweared after liberation of the concentration camp in Buchenwald. And and it's so that we are here in the topography des Terrors. It was in the 30s and 40s until the end of the Nazi time. It was the headquarter of the Gestapo and Reichssicherheitshauptamt. And my father was arrested here in mid of September of 42 until 22nd December of 42. It was the last day in his life, and he came from the house arrest here. It's nearby where we are sitting to the execution place in Plötzensee, together with 12 of other comrades who were sentenced by death, by the highest military court 3 days before. My mother and my father were arrested in mid of September, and my mother was pregnant, and I was born in a prison here in Berlin, and my father saw me one time. I don't know if my mother had to go in this Gestapo house, or my father, maybe he came to the women prison where we live. And my mother were sentenced by death too in January, and she wrote a petition of grace. And this petition of grace were denied by Hitler, not only for my mother, for 12 other women too, and they are executed on 5th of August. And the mother of my mother, my grandmother, picked up me 3 days before. And later my grandmother died, and then I came to my grandparents, the parents of my father, and after the war. And the history of the Red Orchestra, so named by the Gestapo, was every time present in my family. And I remember that after the war and later came friends of my father, for instance. They were friends in a circle, and who knew them from the school. And later in the Nazi time, they were in the friend circle, in the resistance circle. And so I knew step by step more about my father, more than about my mother. And later, as I was after the school, and then I noticed that that was not only the fate of my parents. They were connected with a great group, about 120 people were arrested in autumn 42, and this people were part of the Red Orchestra, it named. And my father was a operator, a radio operator, and I thought that he every time was duty in this action, yes. Yes, and he was, for me, he was a hero, but it was not so easy to live with heroes as a child, yes. It was the Cold War, yes, and it was so that, for instance, the resistance of my parents and their friends, it was so that more and more journalists or historians in Western Germany said, no, the Red Orchestra, they didn't belong to the German resistance movement. They were part of a Soviet spy net in Western Europe, yes, they worked for the intelligence, for the Soviet intelligence services, and yes, and that was not okay. And it was so that later I thought that in the 50s the name Red Orchestra was a synonym for Soviet spy in the present, yes, and. And it was so that the Red Orchestra grew up more and more, yes. Thousands of people took part, yes. 100 radio operators worked in this time, yes. And it was not the view from the history, it was the view from the present anti-communist attitude and, yes, and the Cold War, yes. It was this Cold War view on the history. But this silence was introduced by the Soviets, yes. They were not interested in speaking about this Red Orchestra. Soviet ambassador gave us the order, and he said, it was that the Soviet people and the Soviet government was proud that German fought together with the Soviets against the fascism. It was able to discuss my questions with collaborators of the intelligence service, not officials, unofficial, yes, but they were interested in this case of Red Orchestra 2, and I asked it is possible, I was very interested to see the messages who sent my father to Moscow by radio. And then I met one man, and he was in an archive, and he said we didn't get any messages from Germany, from Berlin, yes? But in the Western Germany book of a journalist by Spiegel, yes, he wrote 500 messages came from were sent from Berlin to Moscow, yes, and my father was yes, was an organizer to send these messages, and so I was in an archive of the Comintern, then in East Germany, in a great book about the history of the German working movement, yes, about the time of resistance in the it's there I read that that the leaders of the Communist Party who lived in Moscow and say yes, they conducted the groups in Berlin, yes, and I looked for evidences, yes, but I didn't evidences, yes, it was a lie too, yes, to the many lies which I found. In 42 here in Berlin was a great anti-Soviet exhibition, the Soviet Paradise, yes, in May. It was so that the essential aims were not reached in the last autumn, and they had a lot of problems in the Eastern Front, and the German army were yes were condemned before Moscow, in front of Moscow, and so Goebbels decided we must do more for the inner front, yes, and so they erected a big exhibition to the so-called Soviet Paradise. One person made a proposal: we can make stickers. Yes, and they made stickers, about 1,000 stickers, permanent exhibition, the Nazi paradise, hunger, Gestapo, war, how long much, yes, and it was a small sticker, and the discussion was now it is too danger, yes, to do that. And it was so that they hoped that the people realized that in Berlin that the opponents are in this town. They are active, yes. It was a small view. Here is an alternative. Yes, he has resistance or thinking over what I do in this time. Yes, and this is, for instance, this is possible in this non-structure. The Gestapo made a big report for the, not for themselves, but for Hitler, Göring, and other. And they began in France, in Belgium, in Holland, and in Germany. And so they constructed the organization, which didn't exist in this form. But this was possible after breaking the wall, because the interest of the Communist Party in the GDR was not to take anything what the which the Soviet comrades didn't understand and didn't agree it. Yes, and the history of the party was not the reality of the situation for the German communist for the difficult situation of German communist in the time between 33 until 45. After breaking the wall, it was possible to think over about all these questions without consider the different interests. The history of the Red Orchestra accompanied me, and it's so that if I would be invited to tell about the story in schools, for instance, or younger peoples or older peoples, then I try to speak about the people and not about the history of the organization. Yes, in Germany, it shows that the political resistance movement and the victims of fascism, that is only for the Germans a small minority, yes? And in the small minority you find the people of the plot of the 20th of July, yes? This is the most important narrative in this country. Some of the remembrance to German resistance is too concentrated to the 20th of July, and then we have a memory day of victims. We have 2 days: the Resistance Day of 20th of July, but in the speeches of politicians and others, the other resistance groups, they say yes, there were other two, but in the center it's only that. And I proposed that in this time it would be good if if people with other experience in or who belonged to other resistance group can speech too on this occasion. I have the impression that they didn't interested in this country in which they live now, not so really, yes. And but I believe I'm an optimist, yes. I believe that we must prepare this better, yes, to consider their positions to that, yes. It's not so that I condemned that they are not interested. I want to know why, yes, and what is possible. Our organization organized, for instance, activities against the NPD, that's a Nazi party here. It's a small party, but they have a lot of youngsters, and in the surrounding of the party, they have connected to activities, to activists who not only demonstrated against migrants and refugees, they try to they try to beat them, yes, and hurt them, or they murdered them. Yes, it's a small in the small group you find activists with different crimes, but the crimes more crimes against persons who they didn't like it. Not only migrants, only disabled persons and left-wing persons and other persons. Yes, we appealed to the policy to not only condemn this party must be possible that this party must forbidden, and we collected science, for instance, 5 years ago, 170,000 science of people. We are going to the streets, yes, with our lists, and we have a good reaction from the peoples, and we appealed to stop this cooperation, yes, between the Verfassungsschutz with the NPD, yes, and the Ministry of Energy Affairs said, oh, not, we need that, yes, and it was so. You record that the so-called National Socialist Underground, yes, they killed in the last 10 years 10 people, maybe more, yes, it was so that the policy and Verfassungsschutz and so they had information about these people, but they thought that these people are not responsible for this. They thought that the migrants and in the surrounding the migrants crime activities of Turks, Greeks and so on, yes? We have problems with Nazis, yes? A real problem. In the years from the 90s to today, about 180 persons were killed by right-wing reasons and right-wing peoples, and it was so long years that we are a democracy and all is good, and we learned all of the history, yes, and okay, there are different people, different guys, and but it's not the mainstream. The mainstream is good, yes, and then we have the right wings and the left wings, yes, extremists, yes, but when we demonstrated, then against the Nazis, and we are often on the street, then we say, yes, the streets and the places didn't belong to the Nazis and racists, yes? We can't tolerate it, yes, as a normal situation. It's not normal when these people with their speeches and their thoughts in this society made propaganda. The attitude in this society changed in the last years. Thank our strength and influence too, I believe. They accept and the Nazi ideology, yes, and it's a continuation of Nazi ideology, yeah, what they do, what they think, and what they celebrated, yes. Forking racist, yes, for Germans, yeah, we are Germans and we are the best of the world, and the foreigners had to go, yes, the migrants and refugees, we didn't meet them, and these are our enemies, yes. It would be better, like in the Nazi time, they have the slavery, the foreigners, yes, and here, in racists, you have the connections to the mid of the society, yes. There you have anti-Semitism and you have racism, yes, against foreigners and migrants and refugees. I can't well live in a country if I know that there are living people who you have the same aims like the National Socialists in the Nazi time. And that don't belong in the 21st century.